They are sitting in India. We are separated just because of this CARA business unit. Milord, what is happening? Milord, first of all, Milord, they are getting the data.
Your client is single.
My client is single. She doesn't propose to marry. I have adopted my brother's two children. He is divorced. His wife is dead. Milord, what happens to the children? He's bringing them up with the help of my mother. The children don't know who is the father, who is the mother, and who is the grandmother.
But how do we get around Regulation 67?
I give you the answer, Milord. Milord, what is happening? If your lordship may just have, first of all, your lordship may have Section 60 on page 19. Milord, the answer, sorry. Milord, can I explain what has happened? Milord, there were two judgments of the Punjab Haryana High Court. I was in amicus there. Then there was a judgment of the Delhi High Court, which said once there is a Hindu adoption, CARA can't do anything. They just have to get a verification if they want to. District magistrate issues a certificate. Milord, they have gone to the extent of taking out the word court and replacing by a word district magistrate, which is actually done murder to the adoption. One. Two, that part. Now, Milord.
That has been actually stayed by the Bombay High Court. No?
Milord, but it is getting chaos because the district magistrate has no application of mine. He just stamps a certificate and gives it. Milord, it has become a laughing stock, honestly. Now, Milord, that part. Milord, what they did after these two judgments, these judgments said you have nothing to do with the adoption under HAMA. They are irreversible. Once giving and taking takes place, that's the end of the story.
Then they brought these regulations.
Yes, then they brought these regulations through the back door. And Lord, effectively what they have done, your Lordship must expand this in temple of healing. They have eroded the act. Lord, they have actually demolished HAMA. They have demolished the CJI Act. Now, your Lordship may have with me section 56 on page 80. First of all, it says that nothing in this act shall apply to the adoption of children made under the provision of HAMA. It's a clear go-by. Now, Your Lordship.
Malata, what we'll do is we'll issue notice.
Lord, can I just make one
submission? Because let the government also come forward.
Oh, Lord, I'll just want to make one submission.
Also, you know, look, your case appears to be a very genuine case because the father's sister,
yes,
the paternal aunt,
yes, Lord,
wants to take the children. She has taken the children adoption. She lives in the UK.
Yes, Lord.
He wants to take the children to the UK. The only problem, I'll tell you, I was just discussing with my learned colleague.
Yes,
this is a HAMA adoption.
Yes.
Once they go there, the children will be entitled to the benefit of, say, National Health Service, NHS, whatever. Perhaps sponsorship by the agency in the UK may be necessary. Because if the UK authorities don't recognize this adoption, suppose a child falls sick, you will not get NHS.
Lord, I'll give you an answer to this. Lord, I challenge these regulations.
Or social security.
Lord, just a moment. I challenge these regulations in the Punjab and Haryana court with a father, American father, who was to take two children, or take a child who was 2 years old and sitting in India for 2 years. Lord, what they have done, the CARA gets a support letter from the embassy or the High Commission in Delhi saying, do you approve this? The American embassy says, child has been with the parent for 2 years, he qualifies for I-120 EURN. They write, the CARA writes to the British High Commission, they say, we approve this policy. CARA does a district magistrate certificate, gets a report. I have an order of the Punjab and Haryana High Court where this is done. Now, there is a matter in Delhi High Court. Kindly come to page 26. I have reproduced the content of an affidavit which CARA has filed in the Delhi High Court. This makes it very clear. But wherever there is no requirement, 5 and 17 is not fulfilled, they say, we will give you a conformity certificate. Because the Hague Convention in Article 23 and 37 itself says, that if there are dual systems of adoption,
to CARA and make it returnable.
Can I just point out page 26? My Lord, on page 26 in the affidavit.
We will issue notice and keep it. Ms. Bhati is traveling this week because yesterday other matter there had mentioned that she was abroad. So we'll make it returnable maybe next week.
Where?
And give a notice, advance notice to both CARA and an additional copy to Ms. Aishwarya Bhati. So that we will...
And Lord, one thing where the High Court has gone wrong is...
We'll say issue notice, returnable on Karo. Liberty to serve an additional copy on... Besides the central agency, liberty to serve... an additional copy on CARA, Central Wo Jo Hai Pura Naam Dekho. Ms. Aishwarya Bhati, Leonard ASG, is requested to assist the court.
And 2 and 3 are the registrar of in the Tamil Nadu, the collector who have to do this checking.
Yeah, you should notice it. Liberty to serve the standing council for the state of Tamil Nadu.
Please, Your Lordship.
As regards, respond numbers 2 and 3.
Not just a point of mention. They have issued 68 support letters in cases like mine. They give a support letter. They say, go and get it. We will get a letter from the embassy. We'll do a verification.
All right, we'll see what to do here.
Well, not the procedure which your Lordship is suggesting and is going is for orphan abandoned surrendered children for fresh matters. Now, if I go to my adoption agency in the US, I start all over again. So it's demolishing a Hindu adoption.
All right, we'll see.
Please, Your Lordship. Extremely great.
31.
But Lord, Your Lordship must flag this issue in Temple of Healing.
Yes.
Because it started there, but it went in another direction. I will be happy to assist if Your Lordship needs me. Great.
31.
Yes.
Devan, how long will 29 take? It's an after notice.
No, it's a short matter. I mentioned this for urgent relief. I'll just indicate what the problem is. There are two IAs which are listed today. Your Lordship, have those?
My Lords, before Mr. Devan will start, may I just mention, my Lords? My Lords, difficulty, my Lords, look out for me today, my Lords. My Lords, inform the other side in the morning, my Lords, for some accommodation for today, my Lords, I'll be requesting, my Lords. I will inform the AOR, my Lords. So the matter is...
Sorry, my Lords, yes, your voice is breaking. We can't follow what you're saying.
I'm sorry, my Lords. My Lords, am I audible now, my Lords?
Yes.
Milords, I'm seeking accommodation for a day, Milords. The matter has suddenly come up in the supplementary list yesterday late evening, Milords. We were not able to engage Milords senior, Milords, and my client are in jail, Milords. We were not able to take certain instructions, Milords. Milords, may I have it next Tuesday or maybe Milords Thursday?
No, I'll just indicate if my learned friend is appearing for the original respondent or for the newly sought impleaded parties, because I'm really seeking interim relief against an impleaded party that I seek to implead. I'll just indicate the point, because this final civil appeal will take its time for, your Lordship is correct, that is a reversal case which I will explain. But the reason why I had to move over here was that in a parallel insolvency proceeding, I am being checkmated and my entire claim is being disregarded by the resolution professional, though 1,200 crores are owed to me because of a certain order of the NCLAT, which I will explain in due course.
Who are you appearing for, Mr. Sehgal?
I'm appearing for Vadhavan's Milord, Dheeraj Vadhavan.
So that is, Mr. Vadhavan is the successful appellant before the NCLAT.
Okay.
So he is the person who succeeded in NCLAT, having lost in the NCLT. He, my learned friend, says that he's in jail, etc. That may be the case, but I am now seeking in respect of a company which is not before, not the subject matter of this appeal, but where parallel proceedings are going on, and I'll just explain that position.
But how can we pass orders against that company here?
No, so I'll just explain, it's against the RP, because the RP has recognized my claim, and he says that because of this pendency of the specialty petition over here, where a status quo, the civil appeal, where a status quo order has been passed by your lordships,
yes,
but no stay granted by this court, he has pared down my claim of 1180 crores down to rupees 1 on a notional basis. But so I am not being given a seat.
But that order you will have to independently challenge.
No, there is no order as such. The COC is that, I'll just explain it to the court.
Yes.
If the question is whether we want to do it today or on Friday, that's the only issue.
We'll keep it since he wants a little time.
Very well, then your lordship will call it out on Friday.
Yes.
Lordship, please.
Sorry.